What's up, boys? Shane here, and today I want to talk about Call of Duty Modern Warfare. So, the multiplayer reveal was about 2 days ago, and we've seen a lot of gameplay since then. Probably tens of hours of gameplay, a ton of stuff to go through, and we learned a lot about this game. But pretty much everyone's already covered all the basic stuff for this. People have talked about all the attachments in the game, how there's like 30 to 60 attachments per weapon. How there's 2v2, 6v6, 10v10, 20v20, and even maybe a 100-plus player mode in multiplayer, not Battle Royale, 100-plus player mode in multiplayer, so like 50v50. And there's just a ton of stuff that looks like it's coming to this game, and it looks really promising. Obviously, there's some issues. The no minimap is a concern for some people. I personally think like the issue where your screen turns black and white after getting shot will become old pretty quickly. But stuff like that often has options in the settings to be turned off, so I'm not too concerned about that, and that obviously can easily be changed in the beta. We do have predictable recoil, which is nice, and we do actually have some vehicles. Like in the larger modes, we have ATVs, we have special tanks. Obviously, we still have kill streaks, and the weapons also have real ballistics. So pretty much all the weapons, based off the caliber of weapon they have, fire at different velocities, have different damages, and that kind of stuff. It's trying to be a very realistic game, or at least as realistic a game as a Call of Duty game can be. And for me, this raises the question of, is this a true Battlefield 4 sequel we've been waiting for? Battlefield 4 obviously hasn't had a true successor in the modern franchise in over 6 years. Game came out in 2013, and it's 2019, and we still have no indication of when we're going to see a modern Battlefield game. And Call of Duty here really seems to have stepped their game up and is trying to eat into Battlefield's market share. This gameplay you're watching right here is from T. Martin. I'll have his link down below in the description. He just put out 75 minutes of raw gameplay, and at the back end of it was this 20v20 mode. And this definitely gives vibes of sort of like a close quarters map in Battlefield, almost Battlefield 3-esque in how it looks and sort of plays gameplay wise. And yeah, it looks really interesting, and the modern combat really seems appealing to me, especially as a Battlefield 4 fan. Obviously, I'm a Call of Duty fan as well, I play competitively and stuff, but Battlefield is really where my FPS roots started, and this really is ticking a lot of boxes for me in that arena. And I really just can't wait to get my hands on this. There really isn't too much I can talk about until we actually get our hands on this, other than DICE really is going to need to step their game up if Infinity Ward can actually succeed in bringing a good modern combat experience, especially on a large scale, such as 20v20, 50v50. This map, at times, obviously T. Martin sort of cut it to where it's mostly showing his kills and stuff. But when he talked about it, he said there was a lot of downtime and not too much. So maybe on this size map, they could have like 25v25 instead of 20v20, just because he did say it was a little slow. And then there were some bugs with the ATVs, such as if you had trigger stops on your controller, you couldn't accelerate it properly. And I actually remember that being an issue in Battlefield Hardline, I think. My trigger stops wouldn't work in that game for whatever reason, so that is kind of weird that that carried over to this as well. But again, those are issues that will all be fixed in the beta. The beta is September 12th, I believe, or at least that's the beginning of it. It runs for 2 weekends, and yeah, I mean, this game also does offer more than Battlefield 4 did. Like, there's going to be crossplay, there's going to be free DLC, and then it obviously has the more close quarters modes, like the 2v2. It's going to have a ranked arena system, likely has competitive. There's just a lot that I'm looking forward to with this game, and DICE really isn't giving me anything that I'm too interested in right now. I'm a little interested in the Pacific Theater for Battlefield 5, but other than that, there's no modern combat coming from DICE, and I really do applaud Infinity Ward for taking advantage of this. Because DICE doing a historical game in back-to-back years, I feel like was a mistake. I would have liked for them to go back and forth, almost like Call of Duty did, World War II, then Black Ops 4, and now we're going modern again. But it is harder for DICE since they only release a game every 2 years, not every year like Call of Duty. But yeah, I'm just really excited to see this game more, to get more hands-on, especially with the larger game modes, and to get more information on that 50v50 mode, because that kind of gameplay is something we haven't even seen in Battlefield on that large of a scale. I'm hoping the tank mechanics are good. The killstreak tank seemed to be pretty good. And it has some really cool mechanics and stuff. But if there's an additional tank for the 50v50 mode, I'd be interested to see how it works. I'm sure it'd be less powerful than the killstreak because you would get it for free and you don't have to earn it. But I always have like the idea of killstreaks in Battlefield, and this kind of does fulfill that fantasy as well. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I just wanted to have a video talking about Modern Warfare, and since my channel's sort of a Call of Duty and Battlefield channel, I felt like this was the best way to do it. I really do think that this game will tick a lot of boxes for Battlefield fans. The beta in September is open, so anyone on PC, PlayStation, or Xbox can get access to it no matter what. Yeah, we'll be doing a giveaway for this game as well, closer to the beta, so don't forget to stay tuned for that. Drop a like down below and subscribe if you are new here. But that's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.